Forbes, we're going to talk today just about your life and your history and your story. Go through all the photos. My first question is, when were you born?
21st of August.
And when was I born?
21st of August. You're my twin.
Your birthday present.
Yes, you are my best birthday present I ever had.
Really?
You're such a cute little baby. Baby in the kitchen.
So you're born in 1934. And where were you born?
At the Booth Memorial Hospital in Cape Town in Oranjezicht. My parents was Janie was my mother, yeah. And Benny was my father.
I think we've got some photos of them, don't we?
Oh, that's my mother.
And where was your mum? Was born in Lithuania in 1910.
Yeah, these were my mother's family in
Lithuania.
Lithuania.
This one?
My Uncle Theo, who gave me that beautiful clock in the entrance. He left it to me.
And this?
This is his wife, Auntie Annie.
What was she like?
Divine. She never could have children. She always wanted me. I spent a lot of time with her. And they were very good to me. Well, my father was in South Africa, and my mother was from Lithuania. And she came to South Africa, and they met, and they fell in love, and they got married. This was my grandfather. He was very strict and small. It's my mother, it's my father, and that's my Uncle Isaac.
Wow.
Look, you wouldn't mess around with him.
What did your parents do for a living?
My father was a dentist.
Yeah.
And my mother was his wife.
So tell us a bit about your mum.
My mother was the most softest, wonderful mother you could ever imagine. And she was quite pretty and she had gorgeous legs, just like Laura. She passed away quite young because she came from overseas, from London, and she caught rheumatic fever and that made her heart very weak, and she was about 59 when she died.
Wow. And your dad?
My dad was 10 years older than her, and he died soon afterwards because they were so devoted that they couldn't be without each other.
All right, so Okay. Where did you grow up?
In Cape Town, in Tambus Kloof.
Yeah.
76 New Church Street.
And so who lived in the house?
My Boba, my Zayda, my mother and my father, my Uncle Isaac, who's a tzaddik.
Yeah.
And me and Anita.
All in the one house?
Yes.
In one bedroom or how many?
No, there were plenty of bedrooms, but there was only one bathroom.
So tell me a little bit about growing up all together.
We had a very big kitchen with a wooden table, a large table, and I was plonked on top of the table, and I used to watch them do the cooking, my mother and my brother. And I learnt a lot from them, which is sort of filtered down to me and my life with cooking.
And tell me a little about your Boba. What was she like?
She was a very good woman, and so was my Zayda. They were very religious,
yeah,
and they were very close, and we all lived together, and they adored me.
Yeah, Martha. Who's Martha to you?
Martha was the best person in the whole world. She was my domestic for 43 years. And I loved her, and she used to take Fran on the back of her and wrap a towel around her, or blanket, and take her to the coloured movie house in Hanover Street.
Oh, cool.
Which would have been unheard of. If I'd known about it, I wouldn't have let her go like that.
So she was going into the black neighbourhoods?
Yes, yes.
And so tell me about school. What was your favourite subjects? Did you like school?
I loved school. I was very naughty in school. There was a friend of mine who sat next to me, and they used to make the most wonderful meat sandwiches, and I used to come late and I ate them all up.
What was your favourite subjects?
English.
English? What did you like about it?
I liked writing.
Yeah.
And I could communicate nicely, and I did well in it.
Did you ever get suspended or in trouble?
Yes.
That's where my mum gets it from. All right, tell me a little bit about these pics. All right, this one?
Okay, this one is a very ancient one.
Yeah.
It's myself and my sister Anita.
Yeah.
This is the Union Castle Lines.
What was your relationship like with Anita?
I used to tease her a lot. I was babysitting her and I put powder on my face. I pretended I was a ghost and she went hysterical and then I had to phone my mother. But we were very good friends in the end.
Yeah.
Anita and I went into a venture where we made sweaters, the best Napa leather you can imagine. And we went to Plettenberg Bay and sold them, and all the big stores took a few. And we enjoyed it. It made a very good bond between us two.
So you finished school, and then what happened?
I went to learn shorthand typing,
yeah,
at a college. And I got a job, and my first job was at Woolworths. I worked for a floor store and I used to measure carpeting, then carpets and interiors. Do you need carpets? We have a large selection of all brands of carpets to choose from. Samples brought to your door.
Why do you put on the funny voice?
Unbeatable prices. Daphne Leibovitz and Huey Goldman and our phone numbers. Oh, Zap Clothing. We sold with Marlene Ryan. Hazen and I bought two cars from the business. A friend and I, we opened a slimming clinic in Mimosa Arcade. They put the plugs on, which never worked. And what else? Oh God, here's my beautiful car.
What is it?
It's a Lancia.
A bright yellow one?
Of course.
How old were you when you met your first husband?
My first, how many did I have?
Two.
Okay.
And so can you tell us a tiny bit about Opie?
Look, he had a good personality and he was a great guy, he was good looking.
Why did you choose to marry him?
That's why.
So something good came out of your marriage with Opie?
My children, my grandchildren.
No, your children.
My children and my grandchildren. I have two daughters who are totally different in personalities, looks, everything. As I say, who do you love the best? Always I've got five fingers. If I can cut one and I cut the other, it hurts the same. So I love them the same. There was Beverly, she was my firstborn. I fed her for 20 months. She lives in Johannesburg. In a very good area, and she's got a good home, and she's very happy with her husband and the children. Cara lives in Melbourne, and David, her son, and she's more than happy. She's got nothing to be unhappy about. And then I have my beautiful Fran. She is something else. She's good, she's kind. She's loving, she's caring, and I just adore her to bits. Fran is the softest, sweetest, most darling child I've ever come across, and she's with me all the way. We lived in Oranjezicht, and they went to school. Beverly was very clever at school. Fran is very bright, but very naughty. She blocked up all the toilets with toilet paper, and she got into a lot of trouble, and she always continued being naughty like that. But she is so lovable. She's kind, and she's so wonderful to me. Now we all live together, and we seem to be reasonably happy, and I did the best I could. What more could I do?
And so can you tell us a bit about Jackie?
Jackie had a fantastic personality. He was full of fun. He was always making jokes. He was mad about me. We had a good laugh together. And I miss him very much because he hasn't, it's not even a year since he's passed away.
It's only been 8 weeks.
I don't know. It just seems for ages. Not 8 weeks.
In December.
Was it? Just seems such a long time. Jack used to play poker with a friend of mine. Her name is Eva Dondi. And she says, I've got a very nice fellow to introduce you to. She introduced me to Jack, and that was it. Well, this is the day we got married. And Jackie's got a naughty look in his eye there. No, we had a very good marriage. And he looks quite happy here. So what can I say? We had a good marriage. He was really kind and did lots together. We played bowls together. It's very sad that he got cancer and he died. I wouldn't let him go to hospital. No, I wouldn't let Jackie go to hospital because I felt that I didn't want him to change the environment and I want him to be happy where he died. Not amongst strangers. Died in his flat, in your room. He sleep on his bed. Well, where I live, I've got a fantastic view. I've got everything I need around me. I can go to hairdresser, nails, food. Everything is close and really easy to get to, and I love it. Well, I like relaxing and watching the view. I play bridge 3 times a week, competitive bridge. And I play bowls occasionally. That's the Western Province pairs. We played for Western Province. And we were in the semi-finals. And bridge, where's my bridge one? Bridge, we went to Maseru at a congress and my partner and I won the trophy. I like to make people happy and laugh and joke with them. I think people like to be with me because I'm not a pain in the ass.
And do you have a message for all your grandchildren?
I have 4 grandchildren who I love dearly. Cara lives in Melbourne and she's presented me with great-grandchildren. My grandson David has got 2 children. Sienna, who's 5 years old, and Mila is 2 years old, and they're just too cute for words. Amy is the yoga queen of Australia. She is beautiful, she's kind, she's loving, and we've had a lot of laughs together, and I love her.
And so at the moment you've got 2 visitors staying over.
Correct.
What's it been like?
It has been amazing. And I love them both. It's Laura and Kaz, and they're my granddaughters. And I'm always happy to see you together and be here with us.
What are your plans for the future?
I like to have a companion and just someone who I can go out with and have a meal with. I'm not looking for marriage or anything like that. I just like to live a normal life.
And how do you want to be remembered?
Honest, mischievous, loving, caring, and doing anything for my friends that I can, unconditionally. Everyone will remember me for being crazy and a wicked sense of humour without any malice. Well, maybe I would have been a better person.
Why?
Because I would be more tolerant, I'd know more about life, and I would try my best to make everyone happy.
What about your own happiness?
My life is full. I've got good friends, we have a lot of fun together, and I've got no complaints. I love it here. People who know me don't forget me.
We're just going to do a vocal warm-up. You ready?
Yep.
La, 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 la.
Oh, la, 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 la.
We did it before. It was so funny. Do you have a favourite song? Can you sing us a bit of a song? What is it?
If you refuse me, okay.
All right.
Why did you clap? Yeah, I was with my two gorgeous daughters on Fran's wedding. I hated her hairstyle. She made grass cookies.
Who? Who's
Fran.
She? So Fran?
Fran made grass. I mustn't say that.
Yeah.
And she gave some to Kenny, who she worked for, and he got really ill.
He didn't show up to work for how many days?
A lot of days. Which wasn't funny. And then she met Harry in his Maserati. And when she got into the car, Harry said to her, "You must shave your legs." I don't think she remembered that.
All right, we'll get you in another outfit quickly and you can just do a tour of the house.
It's a change. You.
How'd you do? Had you dropped me a letter out of Harder Band, the grandest band in the land? Had you dropped me a letter out of Harder Band and spread the welcome mat for you? Now I don't know where you came from, 'cause I don't know where you've been. But it really doesn't matter, grab a chair and fill your platter and dig, dig, dig right in. If I knew you were coming out of Bake to Cake, Harder Band, goodness sake, if I knew you were coming out of Bake to Cake, how'd you do, how'd you do, how'd you do?
Platter cake, platter cake, baker man, bake a cake as quick as you can. Plenty of cream and sugar and ice, nuts and raisins and honey and spice. Drop me a letter out of Harder Band, grandest band in the land. Had you drop me a letter out of Harder Band, spread the welcome mat for you.
knew you were coming out of Baker Cake. How'd you do, how'd you do, how'd you do? And you dropped me a letter out of Hard Hole, great big hole, band and all. Had you dropped me a letter out of Hard Hole and spread the welcome mat for you. Now I don't know where you came from, cause I don't know where you've been. It really doesn't matter. Grab a chair and fill your platter and dig, dig, dig right in. If I knew you were coming, I'd have kept the pot, coffee pot, nice and hot. If I knew you were coming, I'd have baked a cake. How'd you do? How'd you do? How'd you do?
How'd you do? How'd you do? How'd you do?
How'd you do? How'd you do? How'd you do?